Hello friends and welcome to Techi Jack. In this video we are going to run Exchange hybrid configuration wizard and we'll try to set up a hybrid configuration for our Exchange on-premises with Office 365. So I have downloaded the Exchange configuration wizard and let's jump to the server and try to run it. So we are on a server now and let me open the application which says like Microsoft Office hybrid configuration wizard. It's downloading now and it's updating, and let me click on run. Now you can see the hybrid configuration wizard has been popped up. Let me click on next and it's detecting my on-premises Exchange server. So in my case that is server 2 and it's unlicensed. So in order to license this, this is a evaluation version. So let me click on license it now and we'll put the credential for my Office 365. Let me click on sign in and it will automatically provide the license to my server 2, like that is my mailbox server. Key has been applied successfully. So if you want to copy the product key, you can copy the product key and you can try to save it on a notepad. So let me do that. Let me save it. Okay, now you can see the Office 365 Exchange online hosted by. You want to select it according to your region. So in my case, I am selecting it as a Office 365 worldwide. And let's proceed with this. Now you can see the on-premises Exchange account and Office 365. So I just now I gave the online account credential and it has detected my on-premises account as well. So if you want to change like which user you want, you can do that. Let me do the next and you can see it should go the like all the dots should be green, then only you can proceed. Okay, they are green now. So let us proceed with this. Now I can say the minimal hybrid configuration and full hybrid. So let me choose the full hybrid and organization configuration transfer as well. Clicking on next. So now we have to enable the filtration trust. And for that you have to put the text record in your domain to verify. So it will give you the token like it's a text for the text record. So I have just added this record to my domain and let me verify the domain ownership. Okay, it's verified. So now we have two options like classic hybrid topology or a modern topology. In our case, we are using Exchange classic hybrid topology. So I'll select the classic one and we'll proceed with this. And now here you have to put the credential of your on-premises. Though I'm using Exchange administrator here, you can use any other user with the proper user rights for the better security. So let me click on next. And here I am using my client access and mailbox server. If you have an edge, you can use that, or you want to centralize mail transport, you can do that. Now it says like receive connector configuration. It's asking for the server. So I'll select the server 2 to be used as a receive connector. So let me click on next. And now it's asking for the send connector configuration. Again, I will select the server 2 for my send connector as well. And let me proceed. So it's loading the certificates. As you all know that we have only one certificate, like one valid, that is like mail.getsupportlink.com. I will use this one. So though there are like two other certificates, but they are like self-signed and not trusted by other third-party devices. So I will use this one provided by the Komodo. So click on next and it's asking for organization FQDN. For my all services, I have used mail.getsupportlink.com. So I will type here mail.getsupportlink.com and we'll hit on next. Now it's collecting the information and It's initializing the organization transfer. And you can review the object before transferring from on-premises to exchange online. You can select this radio button and click on next to review. Like you can see retention policy, remote domain. So I have nothing to do with this, so I'll click on next and click on update. So now it's initializing the hybrid environment and it will take some time to get configured. So if you have everything done in a correct way, it will go fine and it will say congratulations. Otherwise, it will give you an error. And we are aware of, like, we don't have an auto discover in our certificate. So it may give us the error for the auto discover, but our MRS proxy will be the endpoint for our synchronization. We will use MRS proxy like mail.getsupportlink.com as an endpoint. So let's see what it says. Configuring MRS proxy settings. So it says congratulations, and you can see the organization relationship. There is a problem with the auto discover endpoint and the intra organization connector. They are known, so we are aware of this. In our next video, we will try to move our user from on premises to Exchange Online. So let's meet in the next video.